In this video, we're going to look at the new features in Onyx 21. We'll explain how to use them and talk about how they may benefit you in your workflow. Now that we're back in RibQ, the next Onyx 21 feature that we're going to take a look at is the ability to generate PDF tile maps. PDF tile maps can be generated by QuickSet for automation, they can be done manually on a per job basis in Job Editor, or they can be done in RibQ before or after a print has been completed. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up one of our sample files, and I've got it set to open in Job Editor, and we'll look at how tiling maps work in Job Editor to begin with. With my job open in Job Editor, I want to navigate to the Tiling tab, and I want to enable tiling. At this point, you would set up the tiling as needed for your job, but for the purposes of this demo, I'm just going to come in here and add a couple of tiles. Next, you'll notice there's a new tab here, Tile Map. I'm going to click on that, and you'll see the options for the tile map generation. The first one, Generate Tile Map at Riptime. Enabling this will generate the tile map automatically once the job is done ripping in RibQ. Next is the folder. You can open this to select the location you'd like the tile map to be stored in. We have a new default location in the Onyx directory of tile maps. I'm going to leave that. Next, we have the ability to add a page for each tile. I'm going to select that. This means that each tile will be represented on its own page individually in addition to the tile map. We have a page size selection. We have orientation. Some tile jobs will work better in portrait and others in landscape. Mostly has to do with what size and what orientation your tiles are. For the purposes of this demo, I'm going to select landscape. And then lastly, we have the Generate Tile Map button. If you select this, you can create a tile map in Job Editor while you're setting the job up. You can see that it's got the job name and it's adding tile map at the end and it's a PDF. And it's in our default tile map folder. So I'm going to click Save, which will generate our tile map. And then I'm going to browse to that location and open that tile map. You can see here that I've now opened that PDF tile map. And my job is here, the name, overall size, number of tiles, and my overlap. I didn't configure any overlap on this particular job. If there were any, it would be listed here. You can see I've got all of my tiles in the tile map here, organized just the way they were set up in Job Editor. If I scroll down, you can see I've got all of my tiles here, just the way I set it up in Job Editor. If I scroll down, the next page is a tile list that tells me each of the tiles, the row, the column, and the size. And because I selected to have each tile on a separate page, I can now go down and see each tile individually in a larger image. One really nice feature is if I click on the job name, it's going to return me back to the top of my tile map. Additionally, if I'd like to go straight to a tile, I can navigate to it in the tile map, and I can click on that tile and it will take me there. Now that your tile map's completed, you can email this or print it out and include it for an installer to take with them on the job. Next, I'm going to head back into RibQ and we'll look at how to do tile maps as part of a QuickSet for automation. Now that we're back in RibQ, we're going to go back into Edit QuickSets. We're going to select the QuickSet we want to add the PDF tile map feature to. I've got the default selected here, and I'm going to select Edit. Inside the Edit QuickSets dialog, I'm going to go to Advanced. And the first thing I'm going to do is come to the Tile Setup section. You'll notice that tiling is not enabled. If you were to go to Tile Map, you'll see all of the controls are grayed out, and you've got a note saying the Tile Map Setup cannot be configured until tiling has been enabled in Tile Setup. So we're going to go back to Tile Setup, and we're going to enable tiling. Same as in Job Editor, this is the point where you would want to configure your tiling options. Of course, because this is a quick set, any job that's opened or ripped with this quick set is going to have these tiling options applied to them. Next, we're going to go back to the tile map and you'll see that the controls are the same as they were in Job Editor. For the quick set purposes, the most important one is that you do want to turn on the Generate Tile Map at rip time. And the folder can be designated again, just like we talked about in Job Editor. We have the option to add pages for each tile, which can be enabled or disabled. And then we have our page size and our orientation. And that covers how to enable tile maps as part of a quick set for automation. The last portion is we're going to take a look at how to generate tile maps inside of RipQueue for a tile job that may have been printed already or is yet to be printed. Back in RipQueue, I've got a couple of jobs that I've already set up here. One of them is a tile job that's waiting to be printed. You can see my tile lines here. And then the other one is a tile job that's already been printed. With the new PDF tile map feature, you can generate a tile map for either job. It's as easy as going to the job, right-clicking on it, and selecting the option for Generate Tile Map. As with the other options in Job Editor and the Quick Set, you'll be presented with the tile map options. Add a page for each tile, page size, and orientation, and then you would click Generate Tile Map. So let's generate a tile map for a job that was already printed. Right-click the job, select Generate Tile Map, we have our options. I'm going to select Add Pages for each tile, and as before, I'm going to select Landscape. When I click Generate Tile Map, it's going to bring up the location. You can see our previous tile maps in our Tile Maps folder. We're going to generate a new one with the job name underscore tile map by default. Click Save. I get the notification that it was done successfully. Click OK, and I can now browse to that folder and open up that tile map. Here's our new tile map with our tiling designation. You can see our overall size, number of tiles, and I can click on each tile that I'd like to browse to individually.